Hello and welcome to the feature of the week. Bootstrapping is a group of statistical methods that resample observed data in order to obtain distribution of some statistics. For example, in nonlinear mixed effects modeling, bootstrapping can be useful to explore uncertainty of estimated parameters. It is not possible to use bootstrapping through the graphical user interface of Monolix suite, but it is possible to use it through the Rsmlx package, an R package downloadable from CRAN that uses leaks of connectors and enhances the Monolix suite features with several useful functions, one of which is bootmlx, a bootstrapping function. Bootstrapping through the bootmlx function is done in two separate processes. In the first process, new datasets are generated. There are two different methods available for generation of new datasets. The first and default available option is nonparametric bootstrap. Nonparametric bootstrap creates new datasets by sampling individual profiles from the original dataset with replacement. This means that the generated datasets aren't just different permutations of the original dataset, which they would be if the sampling was done without replacement, but that the generated datasets can contain more than one of the individual profiles from the original dataset. Parametric bootstrap, the second available option, uses estimated parameters obtained by modeling the original dataset to simulate new datasets with the same sampling points, as one would do for a visual predictive check, for example. The number of individuals for each newly created dataset is usually, and by default, the same as the number of individuals in the original dataset, but can be changed using the appropriate bootmlx argument, as we will show later. After resampling in the second process, population parameters are estimated for each of the generated datasets. Using these sets of estimated parameters, confidence intervals for each parameter can be calculated. By setting the number of generated datasets to a high value, you are achieving higher accuracy, but you are sacrificing both time and memory. By using bootmlx function from the Rsmlx package, you can define several different settings. Already mentioned resampling method and number of replicates. Name of the created folder that will contain datasets and MLX run files. Tasks you want to run for each replicate. Number of individuals per generated dataset. Categorical covariate for which you want to keep the ratio of individuals. You might want to use this option, for example, for the number of observations, when you have a dataset in which some individual's data is rich, but it's sparse for the others, so that you can maintain the same or similar total number of observations in the generated datasets. Since Bootstrap could sample only individuals with sparse data, for example, biasing the results. Only one covariate can be passed to this argument. If you want to plot the distribution of estimated parameters as box plots, confidence level for the intervals to calculate for model parameters. If you have already run the bootmlx function, you can also specify if you want to regenerate the datasets and re-estimate the parameters. Let's dive into RStudio and I will show you the typical usage of the function. File Varfarin PK Project MLX Tron contains a dataset with 32 individuals modeled by a simple one-compartment model with first-order absorption with lag time and linear elimination. Let's run the bootmlx function by generating 1,000 replicates and plotting the distribution of estimated parameters. As you can see, the function returns a data frame with the estimations of parameters for each replicate, and this data frame can be used, for example, to plot the results in any way you like, or to find confidence intervals of any level you like. The data frame that is returned can also be written to an external file, which can then be used to define parameters to be used in Rsmlx to simulate predictions that account for the uncertainty of data. Have a nice week!